My goodness me, it's so short, isn't it, that song? I had no idea. Here's us discussing Yabra and what we're going to play next, and the damn thing's over. How are you? It's 6:07, and this is Drive Time on Radio 2, and I do believe joining us now on the telephone as an extraordinarily short record is, in fact, Bjorn Ulvaeus. Hello, Bjorn.
Hi, Chris. How are you?
Well, Bjorn, I was caught short for the first time in a while.
It's a good song, that. It's Reg Presley, isn't it?
Yes, it is Reg Presley.
Yeah.
Now, who do you sound like? You sound a little bit like Bob Harris on the telephone.
Do I? Who's Bob Harris?
Bob Harris is this DJ. He's a legend. He's called Whispering Bob.
And, oh, I see.
And he knows more about music than everybody on the planet put together, and he's a genius, basically.
Well, good. I am, too, and I thought I had a Swedish accent.
No, you have got a Swedish accent, and now you're talking more, you don't sound so much like him. So so I'll just go somewhere else now, if you don't mind.
Right.
Now, listen, when it was discovered you were on the show today, we have a blog that runs in conjunction with the show. The show is the show, the blog is the blog, together we call them a schlog.
Okay.
And once it was announced that you were going to be on the show, we got lots of people suggesting questions that I might ask you, and one of them was, and I've thought about this a lot myself, one of them was, The Winner Takes It All, one of the saddest songs probably ever written, because it seems to be so true. And apparently the story goes, and this is the question that was posed today, the story goes that you wrote that in 20 minutes when you were completely drunk. Is that true?
It's not entirely true. It's true that I wrote it very quickly, an hour or an hour and a half, and I did have two glasses of whiskey at the time, also, to get the inspiration.
Okay.
But I wasn't mind drunk, no.
Now, when you look back at those words, does it make you sad? Did it help you get over things? I mean, it is a completely moving song, and it's so true. I mean, to not hold back in any way like that, it was very brave.
I thought, you know, it was kind of scary at the time, and I didn't know whether Agnetha could do it or not. But then again, it's like 20% from our lives and 80% fiction anyway.
I see. So are there any no-go areas when you're writing a song?
I guess there must be. I don't like writing about politics, party politics. No,
okay.
I avoid that.
No, we don't need that in our lives.
No.
So listen, how did you write all those songs? My goodness me, you were busy for a while.
We were. I mean, we released one album every year.
But how did you come up with it? Because, you know, the lyrics were so brilliant. So where did it come from? Where was the rich vein? How come it was hit after hit after hit?
Well, the truth is that we hardly toured at all.
Right.
I mean, during a 7-8 year career, we only toured like half a year in all. And the rest of the time we spent writing. And, you know, then you come up with good stuff and you throw away all the bad stuff.
Now, one of the problems that bands have nowadays, because you were so prolific, is that after the first album, I mean, you know, I'm not saying writing songs is easy, but the first album is often automatic for most people because they've got all this stuff from their childhood and their teenage years and their first smell of the adult world.
Yeah.
And after that, they think, oh, we've been on tour for the last 2 years. What do we write about now? How come you still had time to live and then diarize your thoughts and your experiences into lyrics?
Well, you know, we had done our touring, really, all four of us, nationally in Sweden the previous 10 years before we started ABBA in 74. So we knew that the song is the most important thing. So we spent, you know, I would say 6-7 writing. And if you do that, very often you end up with, you know, a few good songs and you throw away the garbage.
The garbage.
And I think those young groups nowadays who tour so much, they only have like a month to write the song for a new album.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then it becomes like too hasty.
So your advice is the song is the thing.
It is. This business begins and ends with a song.
Okay, do you still have your beard?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Will you ever shave it off?
I wouldn't dream of shaving it off.
When did you decide a beard was for Bjorn?
I decided that I think in 79 or 80, I wanted to cover my face.
Why did you want to do that?
Well, I was getting old, you know.
Oh, I don't think that's true. I think you've got a nice... I always thought you both looked very cute, the two boys from Emma. Anyway, there you are. Listen, you're on to talk about something very special. which is Mamma Mia, How Can I Resist You? The inside story of ABBA and Mamma Mia, but you've got to play for time to do that. So are you willing to play my silly little game, Bjorn?
I am indeed.
Okay, so it's a real pleasure to talk to you, as I'm sure you can tell from my question. So, Tuesday, the 19th of September, Bjorn, has it been a good day or a bad day for the first 10 seconds of your promotional advert for Run DMC?
Yes.
Yes, what? Bad day or good day?
A good day.
You might want to revise your answer, Bjorn.
Well, there you are. Well, yes, I say no, in fact, yeah.
It's been a bad day, you're saying?
It's been a bad day.
It's been a terrible day, Bjorn, so you win 10 seconds, because 70s rock group The Knack have decided to file a lawsuit against the rap group for allegedly using an unlicensed sample of My Sharona in their song It's Tricky. So, you got 10 seconds. Has it been a good day or a bad day for another 10 seconds for the Italian police?
The Italian police?
The polizia, yes.
Well, I think there is hardly ever a good day for Italian police. So I'd say no, it hasn't.
It has been a good day, I'm afraid.
Oh, what have they done?
Yes, well, an Italian thief accidentally turned himself in after losing his mobile phone whilst robbing someone. He called his own number to meet the finder and unwittingly arranged a date with the police. So it has been a good day, unfortunately.
So we need to get
another 10 seconds. Here we go. Has it been a good day or a bad day for tennis fans, Bjorn?
Is there a tennis tournament going on? I'm not into sports that much.
What do you think?
Tennis fans, you say. Not players, but fans.
Yeah, tennis fans. Good day or bad day? Good day or bad day? Good day or bad day?
Well, I have to guess. If there aren't any kind of news about tennis fans, it would have been a good day.
It has been a great day, well done. Because work has begun on the £40 million renovation on Wimbledon's centre court, which includes adding a retractable roof. When completed in 2008, it will allow play to continue in all weather conditions. No longer will there be rain stop play. So, Bjorn, it's good news. So,
not a day too early.
No, exactly. So, Bjorn, you've now won 20 seconds to talk about your book. Off you go.
Okay. Well, it's going to be released. It's going to be in the shops tomorrow. It's Mamma Mia, How Can We Resist You, the book. And it's about the making of the musical. And in it, there are chapters with various people who have contributed, like director, like Judy Kramer, who came up with the idea first.
Yes.
And they have their various versions about how, you know, this came to be.
Okay, that's all you've got time for.
If they read my chapter, they get to know the truth.
Okay, thank you very much, Bjorn. What a lovely fella. Bjorn Ulvaeus, and now we've been wondering what to play. We think we're going to go for this. I've seen you twice in a short